In the last 40 years, a photographer called Martin Chambi has become very prominent, and he has been the first Peruvian photographer of the 20th century to have acquired a high international profile. And people know very little of what happened before Martin Chambi, and they don't know either how he started in photography. So this show creates a context for that. We present the city of Arequipa, which is where Martin Chambi studied photography, and he was the apprentice to a great photographer of that time called Max T. Vargas, Maximiliano Telesforo Vargas. And this photographer, Max T. Vargas, provided the full model that served Martin Chambi to understand what the profession of a photographer in that part of the world meant. And in this show you can see for the first time a group of 10 images by Max T. Vargas, among them 7 originals. And these images create a template for Martin Chambi's own photographic practice after he left Arequipa and went to Cusco. We are proposing the idea of a school of Arequipa in photography, and accompanying Max T. Vargas, there is Emilio Diaz, who was his main competitor, and we have his disciples, the Vargas brothers, who weren't relatives of Max T., but were his young apprentices, and Martin Chambi as well. The important thing to remember is that in the southern Andes, where all this happened, it's all between Arequipa, Puno, and Cusco. Portrait was a very important genre in photography, and it was recognized as artistic. There was an institution in Arequipa called the Centro Artístico de Arequipa, and this institution held contests from 1890 onwards till the 1930s, and in these contests, portraits were given prizes as works of art. The rise of landscape wasn't that easy into the artistic status. It took some time because at first it was just seen as topographical views of the territory, and it was like a very slow development into starting to appreciate landscape as artistic photography. And in the show there are two very interesting examples of Arequipa photographers who were considered to be artists in landscape. There is Guillermo Montesinos and Enrique Macias. And these artistic landscapes started through the idea of the Controluce.
Okay.
And it was that aspect that I would say started off the conception of landscape as art in a wider sense, and landscape photography was prized in the contest organized by the Centro Artístico starting in the 1910s. This show is a resume of all that, and it includes both original photographs as well as modern and contemporary copies from the glass plate negatives. Is it okay?
So there is also an Italian photography beyond the one you have selected, Domenico Gismondi. Why do you have selected?
Yes, we selected an image by Luigi Domenico Gismondi because it is a very significant image of this period. It is a photography that he took in Tiahuanaco, an archaeological site in Bolivia. And Tiahuanaco was a very important archaeological place before Machu Picchu. Tiahuanaco was discovered in the late 1890s which is more or less the time that Gismondi came to South America. He probably landed in Mollendo, the port that is very close to Arequipa. And Arequipa is the focus of all this photographic movement I was telling you about. He apprenticed shortly in Arequipa. This is all hypothesis because we don't know the complete data for his development as a photographer. But he learned his trade as photographer in that area of the world. He mainly decided to document what he saw. So all his travels provided images of both pre-Hispanic monuments as well as churches and towns of all descriptions. And he displaced himself between Arequipa, Cusco, and Puno. From Puno, he went to Bolivia, and that is where he took the photograph of Tiahuanaco. There's this church and two idols and a man standing beside one of the idols. This church you can still see today in that area. And for us, it was very significant because he is a photographer who, being a foreigner, becomes part of the people. And he, in his work, encompasses both the Peruvian side and the Bolivian side. He is, in fact, in a way, a figure that makes a counterpoint to Max T. Vargas, because Max T. Vargas had his studio in Arequipa, and he also had a studio in La Paz, which was run parallel to the Arequipa studio. Mm-hmm. And the interesting thing is that it was during his travels too that he also took photographs of the territory and of the different traditions and customs of the different groups of people living in the area. So Gismondi, who probably learned his trade partly with Max T. Vargas, was actually a photographer that competed with him in the whole area of Arequipa, Puno, Bolivia.